day after day we go. We go into their world when no one else will. We go so that we may step into their lives and in doing so come to know who they are. As long as there are kids, we will continue to go. In many ways, it's a world in reality cut off from our own. This is where we go because we know they are desperate for someone to come. Casper Young Life sends leaders into the world of teenagers and the surrounding community every week. From the outside, it seems to be a world that is so full of life and energy, a limitless potential. We find ourselves saying that these will be some of the best years of their lives. From dances to homecomings, to football games and school plays, from spring breaks and choir trips until the first time they sit behind the wheel of a car, life seems to be exploding all around them. But in the midst of the sea of smiling faces and laughter, there's something that goes on below, something beneath, in a world that adults aren't really let into all the time. But if we really take the time to step into a kid's life, if we invest in them just as they are, the masks come off, that world is opened up to us, and sometimes we get to see that smiles hide pain, and laughter sometimes can disguise brokenness. And we find that oftentimes kids are just buying their time until they lay their head down at the end of the day. This is the reason we must go.
As long as kids seek to find identity in the opinion of their friends, we will go to them. As long as they continue to look for love in all the wrong places.
As long as kids walk through the halls acting like everything is fine, while being ripped apart by the brokenness of their families.
As long as they give themselves away in a desperate attempt to find worth.
As long as they try to numb the emptiness and loneliness with drugs and alcohol.
As long as they're seeking the approval of others, afraid they're one step away from losing it all.
We will go to them.
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 When a heart breaks.
We do not believe that they have been left alone to fend for themselves in a harsh and broken world. We believe that God is recklessly in love with them, and we believe that He has made this story known in Jesus. We believe that He has stepped into this world to rescue us, and that this changes everything. Because Jesus comes and says, today doesn't have to be like yesterday. Today can be different. You don't have to live like this anymore. The old way is gone, and a new day has come. This is why we as Young Life leaders step into the lives of kids, to win their friendship and trust in the hope of building authentic relationships, so that we can have the opportunity to share our lives with them and help encounter this living God.
I first met my Young Life leader when I was invited to a club. A friend had invited me, and I met this guy, and the next thing I knew, he was showing up, investing in my life, and just wanted to hang out.
Every week we got together over at her house, and it was so obvious that she loved us and cared about us and wanted what was best for us.
He saw potential in me I didn't even know I had.
My youth leader in high school really saw an interest in me and found opportunities for me that made me become a better person and, you know, show me where I wanted to go with my life and the person that I wanted to be with my life. Without her influence in my life, I honestly don't know where I'd be today.
He believed in me.
My youth leaders helped shape what I would do in the future.
I met my Young Life leader 16 years ago, and he cared about all the things I cared about.
Marcella Swenson.
Coach Matson.
Tim and Ebony.
Coach Hopkins.
Gary Greisengod.
My Young Life leader and good friend is Mike Billingsley.
Josh Bennett introduced me to Jesus, and my life will never be the same.
Casper Young Life currently sends leaders like this every week into the schools. We are active with our ministry to junior high students, Wildlife. We had our first club last February, and since then an average of 35 kids have shown up every couple weeks to laugh, sing, play games, and hear about a God who loves them and relentlessly pursues them. Students are showing up from all over town, from CY Middle School, Dean Morgan Junior High, Casper Classical Academy, and Centennial. 2 years ago, Casper Young Life didn't exist, but last June we took 16 students to camp for 5 days in Colorado. There's currently one staff person and 8 volunteer leaders reaching Casper. In the coming year, we will be preparing to start our work with the thousands of high school students in our area. This all comes together in that we are compelled to go, compelled by the God who came to us. We have been given the incredible blessing to take part in the redemptive work of Jesus. There are over 6,000 teenagers in the Casper area, and 5,000 of them don't have Young Life or Wildlife in their schools. With our current resources, it would be very difficult to grow and sustain ministries there. This is unacceptable to us because Young Life is for every kid, everywhere, for eternity. Our goal is that every teenager in the Casper area would have the opportunity to hear about Jesus and His love. Reaching 6,000 kids seems impossible, but reaching the next kid is not. So we fervently pray that God would provide us with financial resources and adults to step into the lives of kids. We pray that God would open doors for us to have ministries at NCHS, Kelly Walsh High School, and Roosevelt High. And what about the pregnant teens or teens who have babies that need special support and care? What about the teens with disabilities that are longing for a place to fit in? How about the students that attend Midwest? Up and walk away, they walk away. Every ounce of time, energy, and money that we spend reaching kids is worth it, because their lives are being changed for eternity.
Dear Lord, give us the teenagers, that we may lead them to Thee. Our hearts ache for the millions of young people who remain untouched by the gospel, and for the tragically large portion of those who have dropped by the wayside and find themselves without spiritual guidance. Help us to give them a chance, O Father, a chance to become aware of Thy Son's beauty and healing power in the might of the Holy Spirit. O Lord Jesus, give us the teenagers, each one at least long enough for a meaningful confrontation with Thee. We are at best unprofitable servants, but Thy grace is sufficient. O Thou Holy Spirit, give us the teenagers, for we love them and know them to be awfully lonely. Dear Lord, give us the teenagers.